She is one of the most mysterious women in Chinese history, but still notable enough to have been recorded by the grand historian Sima Qian over 100 years after her death. The first emperor, Qin Shi Huang, built a tower in her birthplace to commemorate her after her death. She was as rich as a Rockefeller and even controlled a private army. But she wasn't an empress, princess, or royal consort. She was, according to the historian, a mere merchant. What then made her so special? Her only recorded name is Qing, for pure or honest. But since she came from the region then called Ba Shu, today's Chongqing and Sichuan, she is known as Ba Qing. She died at approximately 50 years of age in the first emperor's palace at Xianyong in the last years of his reign. The emperor had her remains returned to her birthplace. The emperor did not outlive her by long, dying himself in 210 BC, also around 50 years of age. The relationship between the emperor Qin Shi Huang and the female merchant Ba Qing seems one of the great mysteries of Chinese history.
Qing Ying Zhao 他们几代传承下来的这个产业，能够把它发展得很好，管理得很好，所以说呢，这个消息呢传到秦始皇那儿，秦始皇呢，哎，对他很尊敬，啊，就是把他请了去啊，啊，不以这个臣民那么样一个等级的差别，哎，来鄙视，而是以高贵的客人。
Of Chu. The scale of Ba Qing's interests must have made her a powerful figure in the area, quite possibly with royal connections.
根据一些学者的推测来说，他家里边呢有仆人上千，就童仆上千。 有这个私家军那个保镖，有2500个，说他家的那个仆仆徒属，就是依附于他们家，维持生计的大概上万。好，这个这些是很多是带有推测性的，但是这些推测是可信的。还有人就前些年就根据那个来算，就算他们的基本生活费按8块钱一天。 按照他们的这个，6块钱一天，按照他们的那个，最低工资800块钱算的话，那么要养活这些人4000万，跟亲同时或者稍稍靠后几年的那些人的情况来看，是可靠的。Such
a sizable undertaking could not but come to the attention of the rulers of the state. After unifying all of the warring states into his domain, Emperor Qin Shi Huang showed much concern to develop the economy by standardizing weights and measures, and the units of currency, amongst other things. Nonetheless, in traditional culture, both before and after, the social status of merchants and traders was not of the highest.
他是国家的政策呀，是打击这个排斥这个工商业者。他鼓励发展农业，他重视农业。这个把这个工商业者呀视为这个二等 二等人，二等罪犯。如果要是朝廷要国家要是出兵打仗呢，第一类是先调这个犯人，然后呢就调这个工商业者，所以这个工商业者呀，他等于二等罪犯。
When Minister Sheng Yang started to reform in the state of Qin in the mid-4th century BC, he sought to promote agriculture at the expense of commerce. His aim was to prepare the state of Qin for military conflict with its neighbors. He wrote in one of his books, "The farmers work the hardest, but the profit they gain is smaller than merchants and craftsmen. If we could prevent those merchants and craftsmen from increasing in number, then it would be impossible."
就把八卦符星看成是一个贞妇，那个贞妇呢？如果按我们现在的去理解的话，按现在的那种理解去讲的话，贞就是贞操，操是贞操，贞妇就是一个很讲贞洁的女人。
The story goes that Qing got married when she was 18 years old. One year later, her father-in-law died, and when she was 22, her husband died. With no children to raise and no siblings to help her, she took on the running of the whole Cinnabar business by herself.
Qing Shi Huang, his appearance is very special. He is, should be said, an orphan. But actually, he is not Qing Wu Wang's son. 应该说是吕不韦的儿子，啊，那是史上有记载。吕不韦让秦始皇那个秦始皇的母亲怀了孕，再嫁给再送给那个秦始皇的父亲秦穆王，是吧？所以在那种情况下，再加上秦始皇的母亲呢，又和那个一个人私通，哎，闹脉私通，是吧？
私通，这样秦始皇一直对妇女不这么好。After the emperor's father died, his mother, the queen dowager Zhao, had two sons by a lover, Lao Ai. In 238 BC, Lao Ai rebelled against the 19-year-old king, hoping to replace him with one of his own sons. The rebellion failed, and Lao Ai was executed. Disgusted, the young king kept his mother in confinement until she died 10 years later. By contrast, Ba Qing was for the emperor an example of chaste virtue in her widowhood. According to the historical records, the first emperor had his moral rules set in stone, quite literally. Three of the five carved stone tablets the emperor had made for the great mountaintop ceremonies when he communed with the gods concern the correction of social customs and the rectification of morals and manners. In particular, this meant relations between the sexes, and adultery would incur the most draconian punishment. These tablets were designed to demonstrate his virtues to the rulers of the heavens, but they also give a good indication of his priorities and the importance, in his mind, of chastity. The Wai Qing Tower was the emperor's way of giving the highest commendation to Ba Qing's virtue in her widowhood.
因为那个当时记载嘛，说那个巴青的话，他那个死后，因为他被秦始皇接到咸阳嘛，然后他死后那个始皇尊重他的遗愿，把他那个运回老家，然后说，然后葬于老家，然后在那个给他为了怀念他，然后祭祝的怀清台。嗯，但是这个历史上面的记载的话，那个都不是很详细。
怀清台。 台呀是中国古时的四大建筑之一，亭台楼阁啊，亭台楼阁，这是台，台呀一般是找一个比较高的地方，啊，修一个可以瞭望远处的地方。秦始皇下令给一个妇女修台啊，那是不容易。Over
the years, Zheng Yinxuan, a researcher with the local cultural affairs bureau, had searched for the mountaintop tomb many times. In 2007, on his 17th attempt, he thinks he found it. The tomb was almost entirely hidden by weeds.
包括异统字啊、阔地字啊、地狱字啊，这些字书里面都记载了，明确的记载了，长寿这个地方的怀清台。我们在现场看见有这个巴甫卿的墓，有墓葬，还有一个规模很大的一个怀清台，啊，当然我们后来所看到的那个怀清台。 历经历史的沧桑，都有些已经有些这个风化了，但是基石还在。The
Wai Qing Tower and the Dragon's Nest Mountain on which it stood had been cleared for modern development. But both the folklore and historical record are in agreement. The first emperor constructed a unique memorial to a woman who seems to have held a unique position in his esteem.
Wai Qing Tai 呢，就是纪念寡妇卿的这个台子，表示我对于这个人的一种怀念，啊，一种尊敬。八寡妇卿。
他作为一个炼丹砂的寡妇，他为什么受到秦始皇那么高的礼遇？秦始皇以为征服而克之，征服是秦始皇对他的一个很高的评价，克之给他很高的待遇，而且为主女怀清台，为他专门筑了一个纪念性的高台，来纪念和表彰他，因为这个地位。
So it's questionable that Ba Qing's chastity alone was sufficient for her to earn so much respect from the emperor.
As a ruler, how 那么喜欢一个穷乡僻壤的一个女人呢，啊，一个企业家呢，而且他当时清朝汉朝对于这个企业家、对于工商业者是一种排斥，是一种鄙视。秦始皇为什么会特别的看重了寡妇卿，给他修一个台子叫做怀清台呢？他要纪念他，他要老是思念着他。这里边呢。
But there were other facets to the conundrum of the emperor and Ba Qing's relationship. According to Sima Qian, Ba Qing was able to protect herself with her wealth and that she was the equal of any king. Did this mean she employed
From文献资料呢，没有八寡父亲到底他那个私人武装有多少人，配多少武器，这个不知道。但是我们可以做一个推论，因为八寡父亲是春秋战国500多年时间里头唯一一个靠经营丹砂致富的一个杰出的女性商人，而且还是一个寡妇。考虑到丹砂的那种紧俏性和一个寡妇带来的别人想侵夺的那种可能性，所以这种武装的人数它不应该少，而且那么大一个帝国，它采丹矿它要保护，炼丹矿要保护，尤其是这个丹砂对外的运输它一定要有押运的人。所以这个丹砂，它的丹砂的部队不光是在长寿，在重庆，是面向全国的。所以我们来估计一下的话，他这支部队应该上千人，他显然是一种私人武装，用财之位，是用他自己的钱来养了一支部队。
After the emperor had completed his conquest of China, he had ordered all weapons to be collected and be shipped to the capital at Xianyang. Here, he had them melted down and made gongs, bells, and other musical instruments.And into 12 giant bronze figurines, which stood inside his palace. The private ownership of weapons was forbidden by law. The emperor had been the victim of at least 3 assassination attempts.And as a meticulous and ruthless administrator, he was inclined to eliminate all threats to his life and his power. As usual, any violation of his laws could expect the most severe punishment. So, was Ba Qing exempt from this? And if so, why? More than 2,000 years ago, the first emperor of China had a mysterious relationship with a widow from the provinces. The historical record praises her for her chastity, but is that really all there was to it? Please join us for part 2 as we delve deeper into the mystery of the Cinnabar Queen.